Why do women seem to go after the troubled man as opposed to the healthy man?
I think it has to do with your past. It has to do with your inner child. I think it has to do with unresolved trauma. I feel, and it is my experience, that when you are with someone, you meet somebody, and you feel this crazy amount of chemistry, like, my advice is, like, run away, because that is not something healthy. That is unresolved trauma. That is you being a child inside of an adult body, looking at another child inside of an adult body, that his unresolved trauma will touch you in a way, will complete your unresolved trauma. And you're going to learn a lot of lessons, but are going to be painful. So why don't you learn them on your own instead?
You know, I mean, she's right. There's something we call trauma bonding. So it's a process whereby someone that felt neglected when they were, you know, a child, or when they have this crazy amount of nonsense or baggage that they carry around, and they meet the other person, guess what? They start to trauma bond. And when they trauma bond, you realize how many other times you find a relationship that started off so great, traveled together, did everything together, but at the end of the day, what happened? They end up failing because that wasn't a good chemistry. That wasn't love. That was you trying to bond with someone that has gone through shit just like you have gone through shit. And what it then does, you're going to get to a point, it's called a stumbling block, where you can't move past it because all you've ever known was toxicity. And I tell you this, and it happens. So let me not waste your time. Let's get to the next video.
Every day is pleasure, pleasure, pleasure. So what happens is the brain starts to seek pleasure rather than peace. And when men or women, when they meet someone peaceful, they label it as boring. And they're always seeking somebody who gives them some form of pleasure or dopamine. And the best person that gives you dopamine is a toxic attachment. What happens with a toxic attachment is you get preoccupied with that person. You're thinking about them. Where are they? Why aren't they called? Blah, blah, blah. And that toxic attachment, they mislabel that as love. And it's just preoccupation. So they forget to look for peace. They consider somebody where it's boring, simple, monotonous.
You know, it's crazy she said that because I remember growing up, I'll see a lot of ladies who like the renowned, the known gangsters, the known criminals, the known thief. And it always baffles me. Why would someone want to associate with that? You know this guy is a thief. You know this guy is a criminal. You know he has been to jail multiple times. But you still fall in love with that person. And then you expect him to give you love. He's not going to give you that. He's not going to give that to you. You understand? And a lot of them end up being in sexually abused relationships. The guy beats them every night and day. And guess what? They are still there. Because they have this crazy amount of chemistry. They have this crazy time that they want time that they spend together. And once that happens, the most incredible thing that could ever happen in their life. And when it gets bored, a lot of the times when they start beating it, then when you're like, okay, maybe I should be with someone else. But one day they show them love and they go back. And it's crazy. I feel like a lot of people don't deal with breakup, right? You're dating a guy, you break up. You don't even allow yourself to heal and you just jump right into the next relationship. So what you then get is a lot of people who are with a lot of baggages and it's unresolved. They've not resolved it. They've not gone to anywhere. They've not worked on themselves. You just jump right into another relationship. And guess what? You are taking all the baggage you had in your past relationship to the next one. And I hate the saying where they say, you have to be under someone to forget about someone. That's the most nonsense quote I've ever heard. And it's wrong. It's totally wrong. For the fact that we are out here preaching to people that if you want to get over someone, you have to get under someone. It's totally wrong. You don't even find time to work on yourself. You don't find time to analyze what went wrong in your previous relationship. And guess what? You're just jumping into another one. Guess what? You will go with whatever thing you came from that made you lose the person that you were with, and then you jump into another one, guess what? The same thing is going to happen over again until you take that time out and work on yourself.
What do women look for and what do men look for? And has it always been the same or has that evolved? we look for a reincarnation of our childhood.
Okay, what does that mean?
So if you were given consistent care, love, unconditional, all that good stuff as a child, which very few people get, but if you do get it, if you're lucky enough to come out of childhood unscathed, then you'll look for stable, caring, consistent monotony. And you'll meet those people who just met somebody in high school, got married, and now they're still together. They just walk their dog on the weekends. Very calm life. And there's other people who grew up with chaos, abuse, neglect, trauma, something like that. And so what they'll look for is somebody who can reincarnate those feelings. And they don't realize it. So they find themselves in one toxic relationship after the other, saying, this person was...
Wow. I never really get to look at it from that aspect. But I disagree to a certain degree. That I don't think anyone intentionally looks for a reincarnation of what they've gone through in life. You get, so I'll take myself for as an example. I've gone through pretty shitty things in life. I wouldn't want that. And anyone that I have around me that reminds me of what I've gone through, it's a big no for me, right? So it's a big no for me. And I feel like a lot of us just want a peaceful home. You just want someone that's reliable, someone that we can count on, someone that, you know, is not going to judge us for who we are. You understand? And in return, we do all those things that we also want from our partner. So it's not just a situation of just taking. You also have to give and, you know, practice what you preach. So I'll say that.